हेलो फ्रेंड, दिस इज़ रविराज। वेलकम टू लेक्चर सीरीज़ ऑफ ऑटोमोबाइल इंजीनियरिंग। इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी ब्रेकिंग सिस्टम। फ्रेंड्स, वी हैव ऑलरेडी कवर्ड आवर टॉपिक्स ट्रांसमिशन सिस्टम, गेयरबॉक्स सिस्टम, डिफरेंशियल एक्सेट्रा। आई रिक्वेस्ट यू टू ऑल काइंडली वॉच दिस वीडियो। द लिंक ऑफ दिस वीडियो इज़ इन डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स। And also I request you kindly like, subscribe and share my YouTube channel. So let's begin with braking system. In this video we will cover following topics: needs of braking system, types of braking system, construction, working and application of mechanical type braking system. In mechanical type braking system we will going to study drum type and disc type braking system. So let's begin. First, we have to understand on which principle the brake is working. Friends, there are various components in vehicle we will study in last lecture. So brake is a major control component in the vehicle. It is also required to stop the vehicle within smallest possible distance. Means the main function of the brake is to stop the vehicle within smallest possible distance. This is done by converting kinetic energy of the vehicle to the heat energy which is dissipated in the atmosphere. So this is the basic principle of the braking system. Then deceleration is the main function of the brake. Deceleration, it means to decrease the speed of the vehicle. When we apply the brake to the wheel, then braking force is created, and this braking force is opposes the speed of the vehicle, and due to which the speed is going to decrease. Let me study the braking types of braking system. So here there are four major types of braking system. First one is a mechanical type braking system. In mechanical type, drum and disc type brake. Then hydraulic braking system. In mechanical braking system we use cam and piston and cylinder use to apply the brake or to apply the braking force. In hydraulic braking system we use brake fluid, master cylinder, etc. to apply the force. In servo braking system, with the help of vacuum or air, we will going to decrease the speed of the vehicle. And last one is electromagnetic braking system. It is generally used in a hybrid vehicles. Mechanical type braking system. So first we'll see drum type brake system. It is also called as an internal expanding brake. The outer part of the system is looks like one drum. That is why it is called as a drum type brake system. Let's see its construction. The outer part is made up of cast iron and it is called as a brake drum. It is attached to axle hub. Then a pair of shoe is used here. This is called as a brake shoe. It is noted S1 and S2 here. This S1 and S2 connected with the help of retracting spring here. This retracting spring plays very important role. When we remove the force from the pedal, then this spring is used to recover the position of the brake shoe. Then brake lining. On the brake shoe, brake lining is provided. This brake lining is create a friction between brake drum and the brake lining. Then some actuating mechanism we need. So here in mechanical type braking system, we used cam as an actuating mechanism. In hydraulic system, we use here piston and cylinder. And hydraulic force is used to operate the brake shoe. Now we will see its working. As brake pedal and the cam is connected with the help of some linkages. Initially, this cam is at a vertical position and there is no contact between brake drum and the brake lining. It is the initial position. When we make force on a pedal here, then this cam will get activated. And this cam shifted its position from vertical to horizontal and it became here like this. Because of the shifting the position of the cam, this shoe get expand in outer side, and this expansion of shoe is rub against the brake drum, and the friction between the brake lining and the brake drum is cause to stop the rotation of the wheel. Once you release the pedal, then again the cam position is like vertical, and this vertical position is caused because of this retracting spring. So in this way the internal expanding brake will operate. This type of brake is generally used in three-wheeler and four-wheeler.